Cryssie here at San Clemente State Beach. I'm just looking around today, observing some of the butterflies, birds, some of the pollinators that visit our park here. I'm a state park interpreter, which means that I help educate the public that visit our parks about the plants and animals here and what makes our park special. Today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about the monarch butterfly. San Clemente State Beach is a site where the monarch butterflies roost in these eucalyptus trees, like these behind me, on their way to their overwintering sites up in Central California. Monarch butterflies are native to North America and found wherever milkweed grows. This map made by the Xerces Society shows the different migration patterns. They are the same species of monarch, but we talk about two groups. Those west of the Rocky Mountains that migrate to the central coast of California, called the Western Monarch, and those east of the Rocky Mountains that migrate to Mexico, called the Eastern Monarch. The monarchs that migrate are usually the fourth or fifth generation, so the great-grandparents are the ones that make the journey in the fall. So if you live in California, you most likely have seen the Western Monarch butterfly. They are beautiful orange and black butterflies. Pretty large butterfly, looks like this. I'm sure you've seen them before flying around, or maybe even in your yard, finding nectar on the flowers. Or if you have milkweed in your yard, that's their host plant, which I'm gonna talk more about when we talk about their life cycle. This is a butterfly that I found here on the ground, not alive anymore, so I've kept it in a jar so I could show people up close what they look like. They have these beautiful scales on their wings. Here at San Clemente State Beach, we call this area the Butterfly Trail, because of the trees that they roost in. You can see behind me, there's the trail that goes through. And we've planted pollinator plants here, which attract butterflies, bees, hummingbirds, all kinds of pollinators. So let's talk a little bit about the life cycle of the monarch butterfly. So the monarch butterfly, like the one I showed you, flies around looking for nectar and also looking for milkweed plants to lay their eggs on. The egg looks like a tiny pale yellow colored dot, usually on the underside of a leaf. A teeny little caterpillar comes out after about 3 days. The first food a caterpillar eats is its own eggshell and sheds its exoskeleton 5 times, which are called instars. And then it starts eating leaves of the milkweed plant. And it will eat those leaves for about 10 to 14 days until it gets to be about this big, almost about the size of my pinky finger. After its 5th instar. So when it gets too big for its skin, it kind of wiggles out of it and then gets a little bigger each time. Kind of like when you get too big for your shoes or your clothes, you have to go shopping for new ones, right? Well, the caterpillar just gets to wiggle right out of its skin and it gets a little bigger each time. So it does this 5 times till, like I said, it gets to be about the size of my pinky finger. Then, and that happens in about 10 to 14 days from when it comes out of its egg, then it's on that milkweed, and it may look for a place on the milkweed, it may look for a place around the milkweed, a safe place to make its chrysalis, another word for a cocoon. It will hang and look like a J somewhere safe and turn into this beautiful bright green chrysalis. And this beautiful, it's like an emerald green and it has these gold dots on it. It will stay in here for about 10 to 14 days. And then on the last day, you will see the chrysalis turn clear. And you will actually see those butterfly wings in there. Then the chrysalis kind of splits open and out comes the butterfly. And the butterfly wings are wet. They're wrinkled up, so it has to dry out. And it has to be pretty warm outside, about 70 degrees, for it to be able to fly around. So it takes a couple hours for that butterfly to dry out and get ready to fly and go find its nectar. As you can see, this one I found here has a little cut in its wings, a little, I think a bird might have tried to eat it and got a little piece of its wing there. But here it is, the beautiful adult butterfly. So that's the life cycle of the monarch. So these monarchs are safer when they're in clusters together. They keep warm and they're safer as in a cluster way high up in a tree, right? So that's why they stay up in those trees. They cluster together, stay warm, stay safe in the colder weather before they all move together. And you'll see them in these clusters in the trees. And when a monarch flies by, fluttering its wings by, all of the monarchs in that cluster in the trees will also flutter their wings. You'll see them all fluttering. And maybe it's a signal, like, come over here, join our group. So the monarch will fly into their group and stay with them in the trees. And they do that here for a couple weeks at a time when they do come here. That's usually in the fall. So usually right after Halloween is when they come here and stay in the trees for a couple weeks before they go up to the central coast of California. Now, if you've heard of monarchs before or studied them, maybe learned about them, you know that the population of monarchs is declining. So there used to be millions of monarchs all over North America. They're found all over the United States. And the studies I've seen in California, and even the monarchs that migrate to Mexico, the numbers are declining. There's no longer millions of monarchs. And there's many reasons for that. Some of the reasons are their habitat is being taken out and things are being built on it, right? Houses, businesses, shopping malls, all of that, roads. So all of their milkweed and these wide open meadows and valleys are now being developed on. So they don't have the habitat they used to have. Another reason is pesticides. So poison basically that gets sprayed on areas is really bad for insects like monarch butterflies. So what are some of the things that you can do to help the monarchs and the population come back for the monarchs? Well, there's a few things you can do. One of them is to plant native nectar plants in your yard. So native means found in that area originally. So you can plant all kinds of nectar flowers in your yard, but try to stick to native plants to your area where you live. And there are tons of native nurseries and places where you can buy seeds. You just have to look on the internet and kind of find that. One place that you can find seeds for your area is on the Xerces Society. That's X-E-R-C-E-S. I will link it below. And you can look on there for milkweed seeds that are native to your area. And the milkweed, if you grow milkweed in your yard, please grow native milkweed. There's a really pretty, beautiful tropical milkweed that's non-native to California. that people had been planting, thinking that they were helping the monarchs and bringing them back, and they would have them in their yard and get to see the whole life cycle, which is awesome. But this non-native milkweed actually disrupts the normal cycle for the monarch. So the normal migration patterns and what they should be doing. So we don't want to disrupt their cycle of what they're normally over time, over thousands of years, have been doing. And the non-native tropical milkweed actually stays green all year round and doesn't die off like the native milkweed does. So what that does is kind of keeps the monarchs around year round in your yard. And that's not really what they're supposed to do. Historically, over thousands of years, they've had this cycle of where they go and when they go there. So the best thing is native plants, native milkweed in your yard. And like I said, you can find native milkweed for your area, or find a native plant nursery in your area to buy native plants that have nectar and flowers for all of those pollinators that visit your area. Another thing you can do is don't use pesticides in your yard. So many insects are beneficial to your yard, and actually there's a reason that all insects are on Earth and they're here for a reason. So try to use other ways of getting rid of bugs that you don't like around your house. There's so many different things you can do. That's a whole nother topic that you could research later and find out about. Another thing that you can do to help bring back the monarchs is participate in citizen science. So there's many websites that help track monarchs and what they're doing. And Xerces Society is one of them. Monarchwatch.org is another one. And then if you download the iNaturalist app on your phone, there's actually a monarch program on there where you can document monarchs that you see around your neighborhood or your backyard. And you take pictures of it, you upload it, and it tells your location. And you can even put in there you saw an egg, a caterpillar, a butterfly, whatever it is. And that helps scientists learn more about where monarchs are and what they're doing. So those are just some of the ways that you can help protect the monarch. And I also wanted to share one more really fun thing you can do at home, is we have this coloring page. I'm going to link it below. It's on our California State Park website. It looks like this. It's the Monarch Butterfly Lifecycle Coloring Page. So you can color this page. You can see I colored my butterfly, my eggs, my caterpillar, and my chrysalis. You download this app. Quiver. So you go to the app store, you get Quiver. It's free. It's a free app. You take a picture of this on that app, and the butterfly, your butterfly that you colored, comes to life. So here's the coloring page that I colored. And you hit this here. You hold it over your coloring page, and it comes to life. There's the butterfly that I colored. And you can hit this here to see the whole life cycle. So here's an egg. You can zoom in on the egg here. Bigger one. Oh, there's the caterpillar. Oh, there's the caterpillar got bigger. There's the beautiful chrysalis hanging. And then the butterfly. And then you can look at facts. You can push the speaker button to hear somebody talking about the butterfly. So that's how it works. This will all be linked in the bottom of the video here on YouTube. Very fun and cool. Hope you like it. And hope you enjoyed our video. Keep watching our YouTube channel. Subscribe so you get updates on all of our new videos that we are uploading from Orange Coast District. And have a great day.